Elmer Söderblom is one of the most interesting young prospects in the NHL. At a towering 6'8", Elmer made the Red Wings opening night roster last year at just 22 years old after being a 6th-round pick in 2019. But he also was sent down after only playing 21 games in the NHL. That was partially due to injury, though. This year, he could possibly solidify himself in the Red Wings roster and stay there for the whole season. With lots of hype amongst fans due to his size and skill, will Elmer Söderblom live up to the hype? Last season, Elmer Söderblom started off his NHL career by scoring in his first career game on opening night against the Montreal Canadiens. He ended that month with 2 goals in 9 games, which is pretty solid for a first-year player who wasn't really expected to make the team right out of camp. But then he went on a lengthy scoring drought and got injured in January. Once Elmer was healthy again, he was sent to the minors, not for conditioning, but for further development as a player. He would spend the rest of the year there, in and out of injuries and stuff like that. Weirdly, he had almost identical stats in the NHL as he did the AHL. So, after a somewhat disappointing NHL stint, some questioned how ready Elmer really was to be a Detroit Red Wing. Obviously, it's a bit concerning that Elmer didn't take any big steps in the minors, but there is a lot of potential in this young player. His size helps and hurts his game in different ways. It hurts him by allowing other players to be able to take the puck from him because of how far he has to reach to pull off certain moves. But that same reach helps him get to pucks that other players can't, and because of his size, Elmer is great at screening the goalie and getting rebound goals. But we don't want Söderblom just to be good at that. If he is, he will just be a worse Anthony Mantha. Söderblom has potential to be a very good goal scorer. He shows flashes of brilliance where he pulls off moves a guy his size shouldn't be able to pull off. He has the ability to be in the right place at the right time and make calculated decisions on the ice. He just needs to be more consistent. The guy is still young and is way ahead of where most 6th-round picks would be. To develop at the rate that he has to get where he is, Söderblom has already displayed outstanding abilities. Really, on the developmental side, the best thing the Red Wings can do is be patient with Elmer. He is raw. Elmer displays not just great offensive skills, but is also a great hitter, and because of his reach, Elmer can take the puck away from offensive players very effectively. Can his size be a liability from time to time? Yes. Does his wrist shot have some room to improve? Absolutely. But the potential Elmer has is crazy, and given time and patience, Elmer can reach that potential. The main concern I have is that he didn't improve very much in the minors, and I hope injuries do not play a role in his career. But with a guy that big, injuries can 100% prevent him from reaching his full potential. You see that all the time with 7-footers in basketball. The strain put on their back and knees can lead to injuries ending or affecting their careers in a major way. With hockey being as physical of a sport as it is, and Elmer being almost 7 foot in skates, the Red Wings need to take care of his body as much as possible. If Elmer can develop into a 15 or 20 goal scorer per year, he could be a really good second or third line forward for the Red Wings while they are hopefully contending for a Stanley Cup. And I think Elmer could be better than that if things go the right way for him. Söderblom could develop pretty well on the defensive side too. With his size and skill, Elmer's ability to be a solid two-way forward could really help the Red Wings in a few years. I look forward to seeing what Elmer develops into as the season progresses, potentially being on a really youthful fourth line with Joe Valeno and Jonathan Berggren. Söderblom will hopefully have the opportunity this year to play the whole season in Detroit. Realistically, he will probably score above 10 goals, but no more than 20. But look for his overall game to improve this season and probably be more consistent now that he has more experience going into his second season. This upcoming year could be huge for Elmer. Taking what he learned last year and what he's learned in the offseason and probably what he's going to learn in this preseason, hopefully he will take that next big step that the Red Wings organization wants to see him take. It could be a bumpy road leading to Elmer being a solid NHL player, but things fall correctly for him, and he is managed correctly and coached correctly and develops the right way, he could turn into a really good player and live up to the hype. But if injuries play a role in his career, or he just isn't able to live up to his full potential, then he'll just be seen as another what if. I don't want that for Elmer. I'm a pretty big Elmer Söderblom fan, and if he can become an everyday player for Detroit when they're trying to contend for a Stanley Cup, it's gonna be great. Because seeing a dude that big try to pull off the stuff that he manages to pull off is really rare. And him having the skill set that he has at the size he has is extremely rare. And now that he's kind of become noticed, you've seen teams take more risks on guys like that, that are, you know, 6'7", 6'8" forwards. And you've just seen kind of an influx of guys who are really big, but can pull off skill moves that a guy that's only like, you know, 6 foot can pull off. So just that combination of skill and size has become a really valued commodity in the NHL recently. Now, will this new wave of players really live up to the hype like that? I think Elmer Söderblom is going to play a big role in that, as he's really one of the first ones that we've seen at the NHL level. And if he pans out along with the rest of guys that are like him, it could potentially end in kind of a nuclear arms race for teams to find the biggest, most skilled forwards out of Europe. But yeah, hopefully this season is really good for the Red Wings and for Elmer. Playoff hockey might be back in Detroit. I really hope it is. This season's going to be interesting. At the very least, it's going to be interesting with no playoffs, but I'm really hoping, and I really truly think, that this could be a playoff team with Alex DeBrincat and young players like Elmer or Joe Valeno or Berggren or Raymond or Moritz Seider continuing to improve, and, you know, possibly Moritz and Lucas Raymond reaching kind of an all-star level. So we're just going to have to see what happens with this team. It's going to be a really interesting season. Thank you guys for watching. I'm Limitless Poles. Please come back for the next video.
Never ever would I fold, even if my clothes wrinkled. Rich ain't single, but this kid'll make a whole meme. You don't make the roster, if that throat gon' make my toes.